Elliott Forrest here from WQXR. Joining me now is violinist Philippe Quint. Was on a big international tour playing the music of Charlie Chaplin. Philippe, always good to see you.
Great to be here. Oh, there, oh, wherever we are.
You're there, I'm here, and it's where we are.
Yeah.
Let me ask you first off, a beautiful album, Smile.
Thank you.
I've enjoyed playing it on the radio. And full disclosure, I helped produce your live tour concert with the visuals. How did you first become acquainted with the music of Charlie Chaplin?
It was a long journey and a fascinating one, I have to say. I was putting together a new concept of music of Hollywood composers or composers that wrote for film. And I was looking for new interesting material, and I just stumbled across Smile on YouTube. It was a random arrangement of the song, and I listened to it and I thought, well, you know, that would work. Let's see who wrote it. And I scrolled down to see the credits and I saw Charlie Chaplin, and I said, well, that's a mistake. That's definitely a mistake. And I, you know, I started to dig around, and I see that he was fully credited for the song. And so I thought, well, you know, that will be the beginning. And then, you know, YouTube has that function of going from one video to another. So I was thrown into another soundtrack of Chaplin's film, which was Limelight. And I'm listening to this beautiful music, and I'm hearing these gorgeous melodies. And I'm thinking to myself, let's see who wrote those. And again, I see Charlie Chaplin. I think that's where the light bulb went off. And I thought to myself, huh, did he write more stuff? And of course, that's when I found out that he was behind, well, pretty much all of the music in his films. And he was an amateur musician, you know, and very versatile at that, playing violin and cello left-handed, playing piano, conducting even, and not being able to write or read the score. So really, you know, absolutely fascinating. And so from that point on, aside from learning a lot about his life and about his work, I came up with 13 arrangements, first for violin and piano, and lately, you know, also for orchestra. And of course, then, you know, we came up with a multimedia concept of the show, which is based on Chaplin's encounters with the great composers of his day and people that inspired him to be a composer, which is where I needed your help with the beautiful visuals that you helped me put together, which I really appreciate.
Well, it was great fun working with you, and I've seen pictures since of the tour that you've done. We did one together that I was able to be there live and in person, and people certainly enjoy seeing you play and seeing the clips from Charlie Chaplin. And the one where you actually play directly to a certain clip, the barbershop scene, is a big hit, right?
Well, that's the scariest and most exciting part of the story. This is a scene from The Great Dictator, his 1942 film, where he plays a Jewish barber and Adolf Hitler. And of course, Chaplin loved to implement classical music in all of his films. And in this instance, it was Brahms' Hungarian Dance No. 5. And I thought to take out the original soundtrack and play live to the screen, which was incredibly challenging because you basically have to memorize every split second of the choreography that he has created around music. So, you know, this is, you know, just one of the parts of the show, and yeah, it just keeps you on your toes for sure, especially when you're doing it.
One of the misnomers or misunderstandings about silent films is that very few of them were silent. Either there was live music being played or in these cases, recorded music and then put into the films.
That is very true. They were, you know, either professional orchestras or musicians that were hired to improvise or use so-called cue sheets. Which I decided not to use. And further to that, I've actually made the whole orchestras also synchronized to the clip. So, and just most recently, I did the project with Baltimore Symphony, and they did actually an incredible job. Just absolutely phenomenal to see the whole orchestra synchronized to that little scene.
Talk to me specifically about the tune Smile. It was written by Chaplin, and it was a melody, and it was years later that the text, the lyrics were actually written and that it became a hit on the radio. Why do you think that particular tune resonates with people so much?
Well, as you have mentioned, at first it was used as an instrumental theme for his 1936 film The Modern Times. And it wasn't until 50s when the words were added. So I think the song became known as Smile once the lyrics were given to the song. And it's very appropriate. You know, the words and the title is very, very appropriate. I think Chaplin must have been inspired by works of Puccini or Verdi. You know, he was a huge opera buff, and again, implemented a lot of beautiful arias, original arias, in many of his films. And this song certainly has this very operatic connotation, at least, which is why I think, you know, we've ended up with so many different versions, from pop artists to classical artists. You know, there are probably hundreds of different arrangements of Smile. And, you know, main words, smile if your heart is aching, you know, even though it's breaking, you know. And you know, you just hear these words, even without the melody, you know, you tear up, you know, and then you add a melody to it. And, you know, I play this at the very end of my show, and I look at the audience, you know, and I just see, you know, people just, you know, weeping and crying. And these are, you know, these are tears of joy or tears of some memories that was triggered. And usually, you know, I get so much feedback, you know, after concerts, you know, whether it's at the reception or people are writing to me afterwards, that this song in particular associates with a lot of precious moments in people's lives, you know. So it's some sort of a nostalgic special memory that you know, people are very attached to when they hear the song. So yeah.
Violinist Philippe Quint, always good to see you. Nice speaking with you. I'm glad you're well, and you and your family are healthy, and I look forward to seeing you back in a concert hall really soon.
Thank you, Elliott. Great to see you too.